y'all wouldn't believe I just recorded this long ass video and come to find out the damn thing wasn't even recording. It was so funny. And perhaps you weren't supposed to hear that, alright? But this video is about religion and what I think about religion, various religions. And the fact that I take issue with people who, talk about people who are in various religions. Because I think that at the end of the day, each religion has the bottom line tenet. There's something greater than you on the planet Earth. Some of you call it your creator. Some of you call it the creator. Some of you call it the universe. Whatever it is something greater than you. And secondarily, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Those are the basic tenets of every religion. Bottom line. Now, whether it's an African religion, a Christian religion, a Jewish religion, or a Muslim religion, if that religion assists you in being a better mortal on this planet, then I'm all for that. You know, I think the problems that I have is people who proselytize themselves as being in this certain religion and practicing it and don't actually live it. And like one of my commenters said, is that we are all human. And I understand that. But you cannot use your humanity as an excuse for not living what you say you believe in. Because that's the whole idea of doing it in the first place. Is that you use these regulations and rules that comprise your religion to perfect yourself as a mortal or a human being on the planet. It gives you each one of those stories in any of those holy books are there, in my opinion, to give you an example of consequences that come as a result of one's actions. So, when you examine yourself on a regular basis, which is what it's all about, not just on Sunday, or maybe on Friday, whenever you go to, I think it's Juma is on Friday, I think, or whenever the other ones meet, or Saturday with the Jewish religion, I think. You just don't do it on that day, reflecting on your behavior for the week on that day. You have to do that every day, which is why I thought Muslims structured their religion where you prayed 5 times a day, so you would always, you know, be on guard, you know, about your behavior. Because after all, we do, and I do believe this, have dual spirits inside of our being. And the whole goal is to always suppress the spirit that'll do harm to someone else without provocation. The only reason that you should resort to violence of any sort is for self-defense. And that's just how I look at it. Okay, you can defend yourself. But provoking, antagonizing, and all those other things that we find ourselves doing, being jealous, and that's another thing too. I think in looking at, they have these things called the 7 deadly sins. And as I explored the 7 deadly sins, I apply those sins to myself. Am I like that? Do I have those feelings? You know what I'm saying? And if I have those feelings, do I exhibit any actions to collaborate those feelings? Because that's, to me, what it's all about. Because you can have thoughts come in your head, and you can have feelings, and people will never know what you're thinking or feeling. But the control of self is not acting on your feelings and your thoughts. And I think that is what all religions are really designed to help you do, is to have control over your actions. You can think it, you can feel it, but there's a whole different territory when it comes to actually acting out. I mean, that's just, you know, how I'm looking at it. I got my hair cut yesterday too, y'all. See that? It's really short too. I mean, it's already short, but he really, you know, like, took it down to a number one, and it's crooked. And I ain't going to show y'all that. But he did it crooked. But anyway, just thought I'd show that in there while I was looking in the mirror. But, you know, so for those who religions are working for you and making you a better person, I don't have a problem with you. And I could live next door to you and you could practice your religion, okay? And do whatever you need to do to be a better neighbor, to be a better husband, to be a better father, wife, mother, sister, girlfriend, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Whatever helps you be the best, I'm down with that. I'm all for you. I support you in it. Okay? I even come to your meetings if you want me to. Just don't, you know, force that shit down my throat, because I don't really need that, you know, at this particular point. Not to say that there won't be a time when I will need it, because I'm going to tell y'all a story. When I left my husband in 2007, I was just so tired. Tired of, you know, him drinking and, you know, just acting a damn fool and all that. Because when I met him, he wasn't doing that, okay? When I married him, he wasn't doing that. He was in recovery. I didn't know people fell off a wagon in recovery. But anyway, and I loved him, too, you know. I loved him enough to marry his ass. But anyway, I was sitting on the bed this particular day. He was over there doing his usual drunken ratting and raving and shit. And I was crying, you know, and I was saying to myself, why is this happening to me? You know, why do I have to go through this? And I heard a voice. It was a voice outside of my head, for real. I mean, that's how it sounded. Outside of my head that said, why are you still sitting here? And I listened to that, I heard that, and I thought it was the voice of God. That's what I thought at that point. I said, God is talking to me. And I got up, and I just threw some clothes in the bag, grabbed my laptop, and walked out the door. Never went back, except for to sell that house. That's when I came back. But I never stayed in that house again. But after that, you know, I was, you know, when you go through a psychological trauma of, you know, leaving everything you own, and you don't know what going to happen or what's around the corner, you reach outside of yourself for something to help you during your terrible time if you're not connected to something already. And by my not being, you know, involved in any kind of structural religion, I thought that God was telling me to go join a church. So I don't even know how I found this church, but it was a non-denominational church. And I started going to that church. Found out it was one of those prosperity churches, too. So I was already hip to the prosperity church because I had, you know, already been aware of the TPN network. That's where all the prosperity pastors was all. And so, you know, I used to listen to their sermons because they was quite hilarious. Funny, you know, for the most part. But anyway, so, you know, I was in a church and I found comfort there. Not in the people, but it was in, you know, because when people are gathered and they're in a certain spirit, because, you know, sometimes you can put yourself in a certain spirit, and that spirit is in the church on church day. Everybody is really focusing on God and, you know, betterment in life and stuff. So I found, you know, solace in that, you know, after a month, you know, I kind of got my strength. And I didn't really need to go to the church anymore. You know what I'm saying? Because they begged too damn much. And there was some attitude issue. I'm like, y'all supposed to be, you know, spirit-filled up in here. And I didn't see that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just the same old stuff where people aren't kind to one another. Even though they're in the church, they're not kind to each other, you know. And I already know that I don't have to be around people like that. You know, that's my choice. I don't have to change them. I just change me. And that's a geographical, you know, move. But anyway, after I stopped going to the church, I sat down one day. I think I was designing something. I was thinking, because that's when I do a lot of thinking or contemplating. And I contemplated back on the day that I left, you know. And I just asked myself, I said, how did that voice sound that you heard? And I thought about it, and I was like, it sounded like my voice. So it was then that I realized that everything that I need is actually inside of me. But sometimes you have to go outside of yourself. And I think that's what religion does for you at some point, is you have to go outside of yourself at your weakest moment and reach out for something to hold on to. You know, something to hold on to. And for me, it's you know, I could listen to a song, a gospel. I really like gospel. I'm really a person that likes gospel. And I really like New Age gospel. You know, Fred, what's his name? The little guy? Can't think of his name right now. Like him. You know, Fred Hammond. You know, I like the New Age gospel rather than the old Swing Low, Sweet Chair. I like the new stuff. Because it got kind of like a rock to it or something. That's why I like it. But anyway, I realized that, you know, those are the things I reach for when I'm feeling low. Because, like my sister said, I'm a human being. But I recognize at my low point what I need to do in order to bring myself back up, rather than going and taking a drink or you know, involving myself in some behavior that I'll feel sorry for later. You know, I've realized that these are things that I have tools that I can use to bring myself back to myself. So for those of you, and that's just what this whole video is about, for those of you who employ religion and it makes you better, I say A-OK, I got your back. We could be neighbors. You know, we could work on projects. We could do all kind of work together. Okay, because those are the people that I'm looking for, regardless of what your religion is. It's how do you know how to treat other people? See, there's two things that I find in religion to be constant, and that's this. One is to know that there's something greater than your ass out here in the universe. Some call it God, okay? Some call it the universe. Some call it the Great Mother. Y'all got all kind of names for it. But the bottom line is, it's something better than you. And that idea is there so you, the human being, the mortal, don't get the damn big head and think you better than the smallest ant on the planet. That's what that concept is for, in my opinion. And secondarily, it's to do unto others as you want done unto you. Now that to me, that's the simplest way to live, and the simplest, you know, points to go by in trying to live your life. Because ain't nowhere in the hell I would do something to you that I wouldn't like anyone to do to me. And that's why all my actions are based on that. You know, especially if I'm forward thinking, you know, if I'm thinking something like premeditating on something or an action, is what I like to have someone do that to me. You know, sometimes you get mad, you want to cuss somebody out and shit. And I'd be like, dude, would I like for someone to cuss me out? No, I wouldn't. So I kind of refrain from that. You know, would I want somebody to talk, you know, rough to me and call me all out of my name? No, I wouldn't. So I refrain from that. You know, and like any other person, I've slipped, you know, in retaliation. It wasn't, you know, just something that I've done just off the cuff, you know, but in retaliation, I've, you know, probably responded in a negative way. But overall, I try not to do that to people that I don't want. You know, I give your ass back something now, but I'm not going to initiate, you know, no negativity toward another person. You know, I mean, I've grown far beyond that now. Whereas when I was younger, I was pretty hot-headed, and I was always one who'd take the first lick, who'd give the first lick. You know, that was my mentality, because I thought if I get a first one, at least I get a best one, the best I could give you. You know, but today, and how I've taught my daughter, is to learn how to, you know, get around, you know, the physical and the, you know, the uncontrolled anger, because we're going to get angry at people, but that you could control that, you know what I'm saying, your reaction to certain things. And that's what I've learned. That's what I've learned to do, and still learning, you know, still learning. I have my moments. But, you know, that's what I think religion is supposed to do for people. You know, those who need that to help them. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, that's my thought on religion, y'all. I think religion is good for those who live by those tenets, who use religion as a methodology to keep them in the realm of human divinity or mortal divinity, to keep them in that realm. And if everybody did that, Lord knows we would have peace on earth, Lord being any one of us. You know, we'd have peace on earth. We would not have wars. I was just looking at what's going on in Darfur. Shit's still going on in Darfur. You know what I'm saying? Over on the African continent. You know, y'all really don't know what's going on over there in Africa. You know, and I don't think you really want to go over there in the midst of that shit either. But anyway, that's a whole nother video. But anyway, this is Queen Ifama. I am the true scientist, and I am the true terrorist. And I'll be back with you. Leave comments below. Don't leave no hour-long response, but I do invite video responses after, of course, my approval. So I'll holler at y'all later. Peace.